Welcome back to the Chasm channel. In this video, we'll take a look at the new Siemens IPC-127E. This thing's tiny, but it packs a big punch. All right, Shawn. So we have in our hands the Siemens IPC-127E. It is this big when compared to a water bottle.
I know, it's pretty remarkable.
So here you go. Why don't you tell us a little bit about it?
God, this thing's crazy. Well, the first time we opened it, I think we were all kind of surprised at how small it was, right?
Yeah.
But yeah, I think it's cool. I mean, the market trend is computers are getting smaller and smaller, so we can do more and more, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you see the pictures online, but once you actually get it in your hand, I mean, I got pretty big hands, but it's a pretty small device. Mm-hmm. Today, I thought we'd play with it a little bit. There's a few different applications for it that this could be really beneficial. The two that really stand out for us, because we do so much like SCADA and MES type work, mm-hmm. is using it as just a little mini server out in the field. And why that's important is because we can do pre-processing of IO, we can do archiving, and it can be an autonomous unit and then connect to a higher level system. So we'll configure something like that today and see how it works. The other application we could do is this could be a thin client, so that can mean a lot of different things to people. The way that we're going to do it today is use it as just the client, and by thin, it's just a small device, mm-hmm. right? Because we have thin clients like this that we've done other videos on that have no operating system. Mm-hmm. This one actually does have an operating system, so mm-hmm. it's just smaller and a little bit easier to manage.
Cool.
What do you think about it?
I think it's pretty neat. It runs Windows IoT, Windows 10 IoT. It's has all the options you'd need. It has two USB, two Ethernet, display port. It runs off 24 volt power, so it'll fit in your cabinet or wherever you need it to go.
Or your pocket.
Or your pocket. So yeah, let's check it out.
All right, cool.
All right, so we're here at the lab. We're gonna plug this guy in, get some power to it, connect some peripherals, and see what she can do. Okay, we have the 127E hooked up to the upper monitor. Thank you, Matt. Okay, Shawn, so we have the 127 all wired up. It was pretty easy. Now what's our next step?
We're gonna do three things today. We're gonna set up an Ultralight client.
Okay.
Then we're gonna set up the desktop UI. And then last, we're gonna do a distributed server on that. And for everybody watching this channel, we're not putting a full load on the actual computer. We have a simulated application. We're looking for the computer to see how responsive it is, to see if it's gonna be able to support, you know, small applications out there. For example, like a lift station that has maybe 100 mm-hmm. to 500 IO, really minimal amounts of data that it's processing. It shouldn't be a full-blown server that's processing thousands of IO, right? It's gotta be a good application fit.
Okay, sounds good. So which one is first?
We're gonna start with the Ultralight client. And the Ultralight client is the HTML5. It doesn't require any plugin installation. So let's check it out. Let's navigate over to the Ultralight client. Now to start the Ultralight client, we type in the server IP address and there's a specific URL address to get to the web server, right? And then the application that we're using, the standard login, is just root. And so what we're looking for here is I want to see how fast the web client launches and when I click a button, if there's any lag time for the system.
Okay, looks like it's going pretty good so far.
Yeah, we got to the trend screen there pretty quick and easy. We'll just jump right into the desktop UI because I'm happy with how fast that changed. So to do the desktop UI, we have to download the plugin. And so we navigate to the URL or the IP address of the WinCC OA server. And so in this case, it's 192.168.2.71, and it's downloading this executable file or .exe file that we're going to run. It should take about 60 seconds to get that. And once that downloads, we want to right-click and run it as administrator. Tick the boxes.
And then this process is about 60 to 90 seconds. And even on this small 127E, it still took about 90 seconds. So I was pretty happy with the installation of the plugin for this. So standard setup, same graphical user interface for setting up the mobile UI and the desktop UI. And so I simply entered the IP address, configured this, and we're launching it. And the same login screen, same username, same password, we're using the same application. And I did notice that the desktop UI was a little bit more performant, like it was faster to launch, faster to navigate to the buttons, to the different screens.
Okay. And then if people need more information on the UX or the UI, they can look at some of our other tutorials, right?
Of course. We've got some very specific tutorials, and we're going to be making more about the different clients. So if you want to go check out some of the other videos that we've made, feel free to go through our tutorial set. There's one on desktop UI, and then you and I did the one on the mobile UI as well.
Okay, so this one, we'll be working with the distributed client, see how the 127 does here.
Right, so this is going to be a distributed system. So the requirements for this one, we have to actually do a full installation of WinCC Open Architecture. Now, what I really like about WinCC OA is that it's the same installer for a small microcomputer like this and a full-blown server. So we did a full installation. It's 1.4 gigs for the Windows installer, and I created a distributed application, and then I pointed it at the application that's running on the WinCC OA server. And then that little arrow that you're seeing here, if it shows the eyeball, it says that both systems can see all data from both the server and the distributed server.
Okay.
But if I check box it and you see that arrow, then it means it's only sharing information one way. So we're going to keep the standard, you know, bi-directional data sharing. And after I start this application, we should be able to see the 127E and the WinCC OA server and look at the data from both sides.
Okay.
So right here, I'm going to System Management. I'm going to open this. I'm going to go to Diagnostics, and these are back-end tools, and go to System Overview. And if you notice, I've got two tabs up there. Those represent the two different systems that we are working with. So that is the server, the WinCC OA server, and you can see all the different managers or microprocesses that we're running, and then also RAM and available hard disk space. And then on the 127, we can see available resources and so on with that particular system as well.
Okay, so it looked like the IPC performed pretty well under those tests. What do you think, Shawn?
I thought it was great. You know, we ran through and set up the Ultralight client, we set up the desktop UI, and we set it up at its own little mini server, and it did well in all those situations, provided the simulated application that we had. So Siemens, great job, cool little box.
Okay, thanks for watching. As you guys saw, the Siemens IPC 127E is a very versatile device. It's great as a client and a server. It is perfect for IoT applications because of its form factor and its versatility, and it can operate great in a distributed environment. So please click subscribe. Remember to subscribe. Click that bell.